Anyways,
We're
question.
Bob. We are the U.S. system builder team.
Look
We
at me.
are, look at you, we are the U.S. system builder technology team, a.k.a. Bob. The official name is U.S. System Builder Partner Technology Team, otherwise known as USPT, which isn't very good, so we call ourselves Bob, which...
Okay. I can't see you, by the way, because you're... But it's dark in here. But you were showing me some fun things in front of your office, which I just thought were
But
fun.
We have a, so we have a couple of things. So first off, we everybody on my team comes from Texas, and so
is that a mandatory interview requirement?
They told me to hire the best that I could. So I don't know where else would I look except for Texas. So we have to put up our flag, and the other guy that's on the team still lives in Texas. I couldn't get him to move up here, but we have that. We've been testing out black comb in our environment, so I don't know if you can see that. It's
and black
working
comb's
pretty
the,
well.
The next version
next,
of Windows
next
after
version
Longhorn,
of Longhorn,
right?
And speaking of Longhorn, we've been...
Here's our R&D on Longhorn
today. We're testing out Longhorn as well, and it's working quite well. We've had no issues.
No issues with Longhorn.
With Longhorn.
But you're gonna hang it up above your door. Maybe it'll fall on you someday.
Oh, that would be a bad thing. we put in.
Now you know what testing Longhorn's been like for the last couple of weeks.
We put in our work order to get this baby mounted. This is the U.S. System Builder Marketing Team is across from us. There's Mary Elena. Mary Elena.
Ah.
Say hi.
Say hi.
Hi.
Turn around, lady.
No.
Mary Elena.
Shy.
We're gonna
marketers are shy? Who knew?
And if you want to see what Bob looks like, we have Bob over here.
Yeah. We have an online section, oem.microsoft.com/backroom. And so we have the marketing group made a banner for us. So the back room.
So what do you guys do? Other than have a lot of fun, obviously.
We're all about helping the system builders become more...
Help them grow their business.
Help them grow their business through technology.
Yes.
It's all about... We're trying to re-energize the system builder technology community through online events. We've done, in the last 6 months, we've done 111 events. We've done 50-some-odd webcasts. We've done 30-some-odd live events around the country that we go through. We keynote, we keynote events. We do webcasts. We do chats.
Right.
All sorts of things.
Now, who's a system builder? What does that mean?
If you build or refurbish a computer, you are a system builder by Microsoft standards.
Really?
And
I built my own system, so I'm a system builder.
You're a system builder then, by standard. And so if you register in as a system builder, you start getting the ability to buy the OEM software, which you can buy cheaper.
So how many systems do I have to build before
one.
I can... Really?
One. So, all you do is you register for free out on www.microsoft.com/OEM. And now you'll have a whole ton of resources to help you market your product, to help you sell your product, information to help you build your product faster. How do you get the design for, design for Windows? How do you get that on your machine legally?
Yeah. How do you automate the Windows installation without touching the keyboard? So a lot of utilities
to
help
that.
You.
Yeah. It's all about, what we do is we try to help the system builder understand how can you do things faster and easier and make more money. Because the idea is if the system builder makes more money, Microsoft makes more money, and heck, maybe eventually I'll make more money.
Yeah.
And that would be a good thing. So.
And you guys are probably worldwide, right?
We are U.S. only. However, our content is so dang good. And this is Victor Mux over here. Victor's content that he's been creating is so dang good. It has actually been adopted by the worldwide team. So when you go out and you look at the OEM pre-installation kit stuff, OPK, that's our content. That's the content that Victor wrote. And same thing with the design for Windows information. That's Victor's stuff that people are getting. So it's pretty exciting, the things that we're doing.
How has the world of system builders changed over the last few years? I imagine with more and more portables, it's becoming a harder market.
There's a lot of movement. In fact, we're just about in end of June, we're going to be doing a little campaign around white book. Machines and getting into that environment. The biggest change that system builders have found is now the competition with Dell and HP and those big boys, because they're not going to win on price. I mean, period. You're not going to win on price. Where you're going to win as a system builder, though, is by going in and saying, hey, Mr. Customer, yeah, I'm a slightly more expensive, but I understand your business. I can help you. I can come and fix your machine when it breaks. You know, I'm here for you. If I'm calling a multinational and I order my stuff today and I need more stuff in 2 months, yeah, what are the chances of talking to that same person?
Yeah.
Or that person even remembering who the heck I am? So that's where system builders need to, you know, it's basically a situation either they evolve or they die.
Yeah.
And if you just compete on building a box,
your
time is limited.
Yeah.
So
it's about solution selling, providing services, added value services, differentiators, and stuff like that. So these guys are, if you're pushing just parts and assembling systems, then, you know, you're going to have a tough time.
Yeah.
And so what we're doing is just providing those solutions, making it easier for them.
Yeah, we we do it in a fun way. We're not stuffy at all.
Oh, so I noticed.
The way that the Bob team works is, and by the way, Bob became our name at 2 a.m. at the Tiki Bar in downtown Kirkland. We decided that was the best name for us.
Well, it's easy to spell.
It's easy to spell, and people always bring up the point.
It's
they say,
palindrome.
But do you want to be affiliated with that product from 1995, and I think, you know, that product is a great product. It was just underappreciated.
Hey,
so it was before
you're making
its
points
time.
With Bill Gates' wife.
I know.
The PM on that.
The program manager got the ultimate Microsoft pay raise.
Yeah.
That's a great thing. I don't want to marry you, Bill, if you watch this. I'm happily married as it is. But give me some money. I'll take that. But no, I mean, it's just fun. It always makes the name makes people smile. And so every time, you know, we present, it's always, you know, it's AKA Bob. And, you know, on our presentation shirts, you know, we have AKA Bob, you know, on the side. Our email is, you know, Victor Mux, you know, AKA Bob. Everything's AKA Bob. So that's how we're known.
We go by two names. Our own names, and then people call us Bob as well. So
very cool.
Which is good though, also because
builders of boxes.
Realistically, as the team develops and people come in and people leave and whatever, Bob stays the same. You know, it's just like any. You know, it's like the Mariners or, you know, the Rangers or Cowboys, whomever you support. It doesn't. You know, the players come and go, but you still support the team. The team is still there.
Do you guys have the ultimate boxes here?
We have some. We have some.
Do you have since you probably build your own hardware, right?
Well,
you don't buy from Dell, do you?
No. You can look down. You can look down. We have.
We do have white boxes. All right.
This is a 64-bit. MC 64-bit. It's dual boot between MCE and Longhorn, and so that's good. And you use that on that monitor. And then this is just a. This isn't 64-bit. This one's just a 32-bit, 2 gig RAM, and you know, great video card. I've got my cable outlet put into my office, so that way I can watch stuff. And we have a. We just finished building our server.
Dual Optron server running 64-bit Enterprise Edition for, it's called the Bob Brain. So that's our repository of data. And so it's really cool. We have 4 gigs RAM on it with 600 gigabytes of storage. I wanted to put, 1 terabyte on there, but
that still is the advantage of building your own machine. You get what you want.
You get what you want.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you can change it around. It's
you
like
get the video card you want, the hard drives you want.
My MCE Longhorn machine has gone through so many permutations over the last 6 months. Now, the only problem with that is you often have to rebuild after you go through and you jack around with your hardware a whole bunch. So I've gotten very good at installing MCE and Longhorn on that thing. It drives me crazy.
How long do you find it takes you to build a box? It took me 3 hours, but I was a novice at it.
If you sit down and just do it.
7 minutes.
Well, this guy's the
7 minutes, really?
7 minutes.
We need a video. You got some parts right here. I want to see this seven minutes.
We can do that sometime.
Yeah, and if you use the OPK to install, you can install in 19 minutes the OS. fully automated. Yeah,
build a machine in 7 minutes. And, yeah. But you know, so start your to finish, 7 minutes is not installing the OS.
No. It's just building the machine. But start to finish, you can get one out complete with all Windows updates in less than 45 minutes.
Wow.
So it's pretty cool.
Hands-free. And then you can do that in a network. You can do that in a network installation, so you can build a bunch of boxes.
Yeah.
All at the same time. And basically hands-free. Once you've configured the first, you know, installation set, boom, you just go, which is cool. And that's some of the stuff that we train people on through our webcasts and our chats and our live events and online content.
Yeah, and RSS feed as well.
Yeah, yeah. We just started into the RSS.
As good, they're good. I don't have to fire you.
We started in
let me go around telling people they should be fired if they don't have RSS.
Our developers that we work with are so excited about the RSS, and so now they're going to put more and more stuff off the worldwide system builder site into RSS, which is pretty cool.
Very cool.
So, and then we're going to start our blogs are just coming online. Any day we expect to start doing our blogs.
Yeah. Are you going to put pictures up of how to build your own system?
Yeah, we're going to put all sorts of pictures. We're going to do 3 blogs. We debated on this, so on what we wanted to do. Because, like, you know, Victor is really good with the system builder tools. Brett Roloff, who is our other team member who's down in Dallas, is really good with MCE and 64-bit. He likes talking about that. And I want to talk about who won on Survivor and who won. You know, I'm the one that likes to talk about
Survivor, huh?
I'm the fluff guy.
See, I don't even watch TV anymore because I get all my information from him.
So spread the word.
Well, if he has an MCE box, he probably has all the videos right there. Yeah.
Look at the monitor that he has for him to watch MCE stuff now.
Yeah, you know.
Just got that monitor. I'm also the one thing about being a system builder is in a way we're a little bit cheap because we don't want to spend our money, and so this was in the hallway, and it works, and so I took it, and so now. It's a guy got a flat screen monitor, and so I took his big machine. Yeah, so but look how big that baby is.
Yeah, that's
so I'm going to
that takes some desk space there.
Yeah, so I'm actually going to rearrange over here and put that baby in the corner and go from there. So it'll be good though.
What communities do you guys hang out in, or you know, websites or news groups or anything like that, or where do system builders hang out?
Well, we have a System Builder online community at what is it?
Off of TechNet.
Yeah.
But you can get it. You can get to it off of the OEM. If you go to www.microsoft.com/OEM, that's our own site. So we spend most of our time there, unfortunately, just because it's the three of us trying to manage, you know, the posts that come in. But System Builders spend a lot of time, you know, of course, in Tom's Hardware. For MCE, they spend a lot of time at the green button, .com, and we send a lot of people over there to that site. And then what were some of those other ones you came
MCE
up with?
MCE is Media Center Edition.
I'm sorry, Media Center Edition.
Just in case.
For TechSpot, you know, and then a lot of gamer sites as well, because as you know, gaming community really pushes hardware, you know, so it's the high end of hardware. And then you have the business side like NASBA. And a system builder forum and so forth.
Very cool. Well, thanks for spending. Anything else you didn't want to tell me? No.
Nope.
Thanks for spending some time with me and
well,
showing me the world of system builders.
And you can do the moonwalk, by the way.
Yeah, I could. I'm a white guy, remember? So I'm not very good at it, but I can do the moonwalk. So,
well, thanks.
Hey, thank you very much, everybody.
Thanks.